Today I'm going to show you a demonstration of the Flipboard for Flipper Zero. So here is the Flipboard. It's available on Tindy, and this is what it looks like from behind. And it's got really nice clicky keys. And this is how you put it into the Flipper Zero. You just insert it from the top. It goes into the GPIO ports. And once you have the app installed, you're going to go into your apps folder, go to GPIO, and you'll see Flipboard, Blinky, keyboard, and signal. But we're going to take a look at the keyboard first. There's three options here: config, keyboard, and about. So you have your action buttons here, and it's going to be 1, 2, 3, and 4 buttons. This is action 1, this is action 2, but pressing them down together, that's action 3. It's kind of like in binary. So the actions are listed and which buttons they are. So it doesn't go 1 through 4 to the right. It's a combination of the keys. So the action that's listed in the menu will tell you the combinations of keys to press, but we will see a more intuitive thing later. Know that these combinations of keys are corresponding to there. So let's go back up to the actions and I'll show you how to program it. All right, when we click an action, we're gonna see a submenu. We have configurations for colors, music notes, and message. The colors correspond to when you press the button or release the button. Release buttons only work on buttons 1, 2, 4, and 8. You can change the music note to different keys of a piano, kind of like that. The message is a string, and then you have keystrokes. So for keystrokes, we can select from this keyboard. So just kind of scroll up and down, and these on the top are their function keys, by the way. And so let's just select one here. Let's do control. Okay, so that's the left control button. You can also select the key by scrolling left and right here. The keyboard interface, the GUI, only has a subset of all the keys, but almost all the keys are listed here in this list. And this is for a US keyboard. So you can always kind of go back to here by pressing the OK button and getting more. So you can add keystrokes. So we're going to do control copy or control C to do a copy. There's also a delay feature, which we'll get to later, but I'm just going to kind of go over here and select the C button. And so now this action will perform control C. All right, so for action 2, we'll change the colors a little bit. So let's make it green and cyan. And let's put another music note over here. Let's see. Why don't we go to B or D4? For this keystroke, we're going to do paste. So control paste. By the way, count is the number of times that keystroke is going to occur. So 1 means it's going to occur one time. If you did 2, it would do it once and then once more. For action 4, which is button 3, I want to configure it to launch an application and type in it. So first I'm going to configure these colors, but I'm going to make this launch the Notepad app on Windows and then type hello world. So right now we have to do keystroke by keystroke. So in order to launch Windows, I'm going to hit the Windows button on the keyboard, which will launch the search bar. And now I have to delay a little bit, and these delays are 100 milliseconds. So with a delay count of 2, that means I'm gonna delay for 200 milliseconds. And now I want it to type Notepad. So I'm just gonna kind of scroll through here and type in the word notepad.exe. So you're gonna see that right there. And then I'm gonna delay again. Let's do 200 milliseconds. And then I'm gonna come over here and hit enter. That's gonna search notepad.exe on the search bar. And now I want to delay for Notepad to open. And I'm gonna go up to, let's do 2 seconds, which is 20, a count of 20, because 20 times 100 milliseconds will be 200 milliseconds. Okay, so that's gonna launch Notepad. So now I can use the message feature to actually type out the full thing, because message will occur after keystrokes. So I'm going to type in here, hello. And then if you go down on the underscore and you long press on it, you'll get a space. And then I'm going to do world. And if you long press on any of the characters, you can get some uppercase. We're going to work on this keyboard layout and try and add more keys in the future. But for right now, this is what we're working with. So I'm going to save that. Okay. And now this one has been configured. All right, let's go to action 8. That's going to be the last button over here, button 4. And let's choose the colors here. Why don't we do white? And for release, let's do magenta. And for our keystrokes, I want to do Control-Alt-Delete. So this example is when on Windows, when you press Control-Alt-Delete, it's going to bring up your kind of options to lock your computer or restart or power down or that sort of thing, log off. So we do one control, one alt, and then delete's not actually in that GUI. You can see here that we can't find it right here. So we're gonna actually have to scroll through the menu here until we see delete. So we're gonna scroll to the right, and luckily it does do a quick scroll when you hold it down. So there we found it. Okay, so we have control delete. So we are good to go on this last action. Why don't we add a music note as well? So let's do G sharp 3. All right, so now we're back at the main menu. Let's check out this about section down here. It gives the credit to the designer. So Make It Hackin', that's me, did the hardware. Code All Night, Derek did the software. You can see Derek's Discord here. Please visit his Discord, his YouTube channel for some tutorials. And we have the link for the Tindy shop as well as my Twitter account. Okay, so when we press these buttons, we can hear the music tones. This third one actually is taking a while because it's doing all those different steps. But now the fourth one is working. And so yeah, this is kind of let us check out the color scheme and see if that's good. And yeah, so why don't we hook up a computer and test this out? All right, so now I have my computer set up. I'm gonna plug in the USB cord and let's see how this works. All right, so here we go. Why don't we press the third button to launch Notepad? All right, so that happened pretty quick, right? There was a little bit of delay, you know, with it typing hello world, but it's just given enough time. I hit the first button, it's gonna copy it, and then the second button's gonna paste it. So we can see that the first and second buttons are working. And the fourth button is the control delete. So it brings up the lock screen right there. And yeah, so this MacroPad, you know, you can do up to the 15 different examples. Right now, we've only programmed it to do 4 different things, but with the combination of key presses, you can have a lot more features. So we will be supporting Bluetooth in the future. That is something on our roadmap. Not sure when that's going to happen, but you know, there's no reason that this wouldn't work with Bluetooth as well. So we will be also having a lot more updates coming. You can see maybe on our GitHub what we have planned in the future. But now let's take a look at the configuration that you can do on the SD card. All right, so this is the SD card on the Flipper. I put it on my computer. And if you go to the apps data folder, you'll see some different files there that are related to the Flipboard. All right, and then we're going to the Flipboard. We see the 3 different files for the 3 different programs here. And if we open up the keyboard app, and I'm gonna zoom in here so it's a little bit easier to read, you can see that everything that we've configured, you could actually edit it here in the text file. So these are the different color profiles, and the frequency is the music note. Message, you know, that's we'll see that in a little bit. Keystroke count if you're doing keystrokes, and then the keystrokes that's sending. So the first number is the character and the second number is the count, and then it kind of just repeats like that. So here's another example for button 2. And then when we go to the button 4, you're going to see that it's got a lot more keystrokes and it has the message in there because we were doing the hello world example. But if you want to extend what the capability of that message, this is where you can hard code that into the text file. So now I can type much faster, and also the keys that are available on my actual computer keyboard, I can type that here. So this is just an example of you editing that. And down here is button 8. Again, kind of a simple thing, but that's how you would edit the file and you can save it. All right, so now that we're done editing, I'm going to eject the SD card and I'm gonna put it back in my Flipper so you can see that new message pop up. So I'm gonna put the SD card back in my Flipper, connect it to my computer, and I'm gonna hit button 3 in order to bring up action 8, which is where we launch Notepad and type a message out. So here we go, I'm gonna press button 3. And there we go, it typed everything out. So now that we know editing the text file, works pretty good. All right, let's check out another feature, which is the Blinky mode. So let's go to Flipboard Blinky. There's a config menu here. We're gonna get to that in the future. The About section kind of has the same sort of credits and links as the Flip keyboard. But if we go to Blinky, you can see here that this makes it into a kind of like flashy mode for the Flipper. We're gonna have it customizable where you could put your own logo or messages on that big screen, but pressing the button 4 changes the effects. Button 3 scrolls down on the effects. If you press both button 3 and 4, it turns them off, and buttons 1 and 2 will change the speed. So you can see which effect you're on and which speed you're on the bottom. The left button, that's button 1, decreases the value of speed, which is basically a delay value, so it actually speeds it up. And this is what it kind of looks like from the top. All right, and this is how you would slow it down, is pressing button 2. So that is Blinky mode, and why don't we make this look a little bit better? And to do that, we're going to grab a 3D printed holder, which I have available here. It's available in the Tindy store. And it kind of slides in right here, and you're gonna put the Flipboard on top of it. Now you really kind of need an add-on to hold a holder in place. Otherwise it will kind of slip around. So it works perfect with add-ons. It should work with basically all add-ons that are vertical. The holder also comes with a black lanyard. So in order to attach it, you kind of just snap the back on like that. And now you can wear it around your neck. Now your Flipper is a nice blinky thing that you can wear around DEF CON or other conventions, or just kind of like, you know, say hi to your friends. All right, for the final Flipboard app, it's called Flipboard Signal. And this will send signals on button presses. So if we go to the About menu, we can see what this looks like right now. These are hard-coded and we're gonna upgrade this in the future, but we have a couple of signals on buttons 1 and 2, and then we have the Tesla charging ports on buttons 3 and 4. The config menu is similar to the other ones where you can select a color or a music note. So why don't we just kind of show you real quick, you know, with button 4, let's make it orange, blue, and let's go back to the Flipboard signal program. And in order to demonstrate this, I have a second Flipper here. I'm gonna go to the sub gigahertz and start reading. And you can see here that buttons 1 and 2, it is sending, and the other Flipper is recognizing those signals being sent on 433 megahertz. So we know that that is working. In order to test the Tesla, we're gonna go to the read raw, go down to frequency 315 and hit record, and then we can see these signals being sent by the first Flipper and received by the second Flipper. So those are the Tesla charging port signals. And yeah, so what other Flipper features would you like to see mapped to these buttons? We're thinking about doing infrared, but what else would you like to see? The Flipboard is available as a kit if you want to save some money when purchasing. It's pretty easy to put together. This is the front plate, and this is the back of it, and this is what the keys will eventually plug into. Now, in order to line up the keys in the right direction, look at the middle plate. You see those two holes in there? This is where those two pins on the key need to plug into, so make sure you're doing it in this orientation, and then to insert the key, you kind of just squeeze it in there. It should fit very snugly. And just do this for the rest of the keys. On the bottom of the keys, you'll see a hole. That is where the RGB LED shines through, so that's another indicator that you are putting the keys in the right direction. After you have the keys inside, make sure that you look at the back and see if there's anything. There was a bent pin on the second one, so I'm just going to kind of get it nice and square again. And then you grab the middle PCB and then just make sure that you're very carefully lining the pins up to the plugs and firmly press it in. And yeah, really nice clicky keys. These are the blue mechanical keys. Now we have the back plate, and in order to protect the middle, I have this back plate on there. It's not 100% necessary, but I highly recommend it just so you don't damage your Flipboard. There's nylon screws, nylon spacers, and nylon nuts that hold everything together, and you just plug them in like this. Make sure that the spacer goes in between the back plate and the middle plate, and then you can hand tighten those nylon nuts on there. Now, you don't necessarily need a screwdriver, but if you want to get it hand tightened and then use a screwdriver, that's what I'm going to be showing you. But if you don't have one, no big deal. Just make sure that when you hand tighten it, that you get it pretty nice and firm, because you don't want to lose the hardware. All right, so I'm pretty much done with the hand tightening now, and I'm going to use a screwdriver to make it a little bit tighter. I'm using a PH1 size screwdriver tip. And as you can see here, if you tighten a little bit too much, the PCBs can actually bend a little bit on the end. So just release it a little bit if you don't want that to happen. All right, the final step is to plug in the keycaps, and there's this little cross hatch that needs to line up. So carefully line up the cap with the key and firmly press on and get that nice click, and do the rest for the rest of the buttons. As a reminder, we're going to be updating the app as much as possible. We have a lot of things on our roadmap. See Code All Night's GitHub for the app and future updates. You can visit my GitHub for some more information. Code All Night's going to be making some videos about the Flipboard. I am as well. And leave a comment if you have any questions, or, you know, leave a note on GitHub. And we really hope you enjoy the Flipboard and flip the world.